The backup proxy is an important part of your backup infrastructure because it is the component of the backup infrastructure that processes jobs and delivers backup traffic. Hi, I'm Kirsten with Veeam, and during this video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can add a backup proxy into your Veeam backup environment. Building a backup proxy is a straightforward process. It's just a matter of a few clicks in the Veeam Backup and Replication user interface to add it. Let's watch a demonstration to see how you can get started. I'm in the Veeam Backup and Replication console. As you can see, I already have several jobs configured within my environment. But the point of this demonstration is to show you just how easy it is to add in a new backup proxy. To do this, I need to switch to the backup infrastructure view within Veeam Backup and Replication. As you can see, I already have two backup proxies that have been configured in my environment. However, these are configured on my Veeam Backup and Replication server itself. And really, I want to add in a new backup proxy so it takes the load off my Veeam backup server. There are several different types of backup proxies you can add into your environment. You can add in a general purpose backup proxy. This is used for agent-based backups, file shares, off-host backups, a VMware backup proxy for those VMware vSphere backups, a VMware CDP proxy, so if you're using continuous data protection, you're gonna wanna deploy this type of proxy in your environment. A Hyper-V off-host backup proxy for those Hyper-V virtual machine backups. And then an Azure proxy appliance. That's gonna really help improve restore performance to Microsoft Azure. And if you're using AWS, you're gonna have that option as well when you add in your AWS environment into your environment. For the sake of this demo, I am going to add in a VMware backup proxy. The first thing I'm going to do is add in my new server. A backup proxy can be a Microsoft Windows machine or a Linux machine. Whichever is going to work the best in your environment is what I would recommend you use. And for this demo specifically, I'm just going to go ahead and add in a new Microsoft Windows backup proxy. First, I'm going to type in the DNS name or the IP address. Next, I'm going to have to put in the proper credentials. I'm gonna hit next, and it's going to detect any components that have been installed on this machine and let me know if this server is compatible to be a backup proxy. And click apply, and we'll just go through some steps here before we can add this into our backup proxy view. So we have our server selected. Next, we can choose a backup transport mode. So there are several transport modes available to you. If you want to learn more about transport modes, be sure to check out helpcenter.veeam.com and you can get more information on all these different transport modes. We're going to be able to set up any traffic rules that we want to apply to this backup proxy. And then we're going to hit apply. And it's just going to make sure that we're adding that server into our backup proxy view. And if you take a look here, it's already been added in, so we're pretty much ready to go to use this backup proxy within a backup job. So if I go back to the home screen, I'm gonna set up a backup job. So let's go up to the corner of the screen here and click backup job. Virtual machine, let's do VMware vSphere. Let's create a name for our backup job. Next, we're going to choose which virtual machines we want to back up. I always like to select my objects based on tags, just more of a policy-driven approach to my backup jobs. So I'm going to find the tag that I would want to back up. As you can see, I have a couple machines here tagged, and then click add. Next, I'm going to be able to designate that backup proxy to do those data transfer operations for me, right? So right here, I'm going to select the backup proxy that I just added, choose a backup repository, and then I'm going to go to the next step of the wizard. You can enable application-aware processing and guest file system indexing for your backup jobs. I'm going to go ahead and enable application-aware processing and add in my credentials. Next, you can choose to schedule this job to run. For this example, I'm not going to schedule this. I'm just going to hit apply, and then I'm going to run the job when I click finish. So now we have created a new backup job, and we had set up the backup proxy to perform all that data movement tasks for this job. And that's it. That's how easy it is to add in a new backup proxy into your environment. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to drop them in the comments section below. Be sure to follow our YouTube channel to stay up to date on all our newest content. Thanks for watching.